Well, traders, I'm just about done for the day. I'm happy to finish in green because my last 2 days were not so pleasant. I mean, yesterday I only lost like $200, but the day before, well, I can't even remember how much I lost the day before, a few thousands. After today, which I'm up like $6,800 and a few more $100 in open trade, so I'm over $7,000, finally moving to a green week. And as you can see here, I've got two winners and two losers. Actually, CLDR, I want to talk about it because that's the outcome of my two trades. My first trade was a loser, my second trade was a winner, but the end result is down $600. And so actually, I have three winners and two losers. And CRWD, which went, of course, the wrong way, and then I don't know what happened next, but anyway, it's a loser. What I do want to talk about is SMAR, which is a very big winner for me, over $8,000, and CLDR, which I just mentioned. So I'm going to talk shortly about these ones because I think there's something to be learned from here. The first one I want to talk about is SMAR. SMAR, I really liked. Why? Because the stock right now is down 20%. I think it started 16 or something like that. So stock started really down. And when you have such a big gap down, you usually have a gap and go. Now the same applies for CLDR, which started down like 7%. But SMAR down 20% or close to that, that's amazing, right? So that should be a very clear gap and go situation. So I posted it for a short somewhere around here, doesn't matter where exactly. I posted it for a short, initially came down, then moved up. Stop was higher. So lucky enough, I did not get thrown away by this spike up. But then the interesting part was that this spike up failed. And once it started to come down, this you could have tell that it was quite clear that once this green candle failed, and then the next ones took us under this green candle, it was very clear that really it wants to come down. So I added once, and then I added twice, because look at the technical formation right over here, 48, 20, 80, 20. And then I added at 48. So I added like twice to this trade. I ended up having, 2.5 times my regular size. Like if I would take this trade in my initial trade was 4,000 shares. If I would take this trade with 4,000 shares, I moved up to 10,000. And that's how it became such a great trade for me. However, I did not manage it correctly. So the issue is not to tell you here about what a great trade I had in SMAR, is in fact to tell you what a big mistake I made by trading SMAR the way I did. Now I am proud of the fact that I shorted it. I'm very proud of the fact that I added. The thing is, I'm not used to having 10,000 shares short a stock. I mean, I'm not talking back on the Corona days where I could have had much more, but these are now kind of normal days. We're back to the normal. So being now short 10,000 shares in SMAR, although I had a good feeling about it, I knew I kind of felt like it's going to come down. I knew we have a very good chance to see it much lower, and that's why I added. But the thing is, I added too much, and that's why my first partial was at around 1 point instead of just letting it go. So look at the result here. I mean, just a very small pullback at around the 1 point mark, which took me out. Or actually, was it later? I think that one took me out. Actually, this very small green candle here. Yeah, that's you don't even see that. That's the one that really took me out. And I could have hang on for another point here. So instead of having a $20,000 winner here, I ended up having an $8,000 winner, and that's because I had too much size. So I took a very big risk by shorting 10,000 shares, and I could, if the trade would have gone against me, lose more than I gained. And that's the whole issue here. Because I had too much size, every small pullback looked to me like it's going to go much against me. I mean, in my mind, every small pullback, a 20 cents pullback, I think it was, took me out. I mean, with a profit. But I saw the numbers riding. I saw the numbers coming down to $10,000, and I could, I was slightly green by then because the win went well. But I knew that if it's going to go against me, I'm going to have a losing day because of the size. So, you know, at that point, I was really feeling like I had too much size, and any small pullback did take me out. So if I had less, let's assume I had half the size I had, it's very, very likely that I could have reached the same financial target as I did with 10,000 shares. I'm quite certain that I would, because a small 20 cent pullback shouldn't take me out there. So having this size sometimes is doing the exact opposite of what you expect it to do. It's being told, and we're telling it, and we're teaching it, but we're not always acting according to it, that if you have more size, your risk is growing, but your profit not necessarily grows. And therefore, if you come to the point where you're trading too much size, which happened to me today in SMAR, although this finished in green, on the other hand, if it would have moved against me, this could have been a terrible day. And you know, if you're trading too much size, when you have a terrible day, you're losing too much. When you have a good day, you're making money, but you're not making as much as you're losing. And that's usually due to a lot of size. So I was a bit lucky today. Yes, I did trust a stock that I should have trust. Yes, it did do what I expected it to do, but managing correctly, that was all wrong. The thing I did today with SMIR, all wrong. I just didn't manage it correctly. And so that was the story with SMAR. The other one was CLDR. My first trade was right. I took the short where I should have. Right here, it gapped down, moved down, a nice reversal. I took the short. It took me out over the highs. That was the right stop loss too. And then it moved higher. And you heard me say several times, it has no business moving higher. Stock is down 7%. It's not likely to continue higher. Like in 80% of the time, I wouldn't say 100%, but very close to. So probably more than 80% of the time, you see a stock that is down 7%, you expect a gap and go, and the gap and go did come. It did come. Just wait patiently, look for the good sign of a pullback, which came here. We shorted it under 1140 right over here. Initially, it looked fine, but it did not reach my target, which was 1115. And then it pulled back up. I had a small loser at some time here, but then it continued to come down. So again, the stock is down 7%. It's not likely to continue higher. Should have trusted it, did trust it, and it did continue. So I'm having a good day, but I'm also reflecting on the things that I did wrong today. You see, traders, even if you have a good day, you need to take a look at each and every trade. And it doesn't matter if your trade finished in green or in red. You can learn by the mistakes you do in red trades, definitely. But you can certainly learn from the mistakes you do when you have green trades as well. So I'm looking back at SMAR and I'm a bit angry at myself. I'm very angry at myself. Large size, you heard me say several times during this trade, I'm very much concerned because of the large size, and I just didn't play it right with SMAR. Anyway, I'm glad to finish in green, and I hope you guys did well too. And I want to thank you very much for being here with me. And of course, I'll see you all tomorrow, and I'm so happy to move to a green week. I did feel, when we started out today, I did have a feeling like, oh my God, I don't want to have a third red day. It's very rare. It does happen every once in a while. And although my day yesterday was just down $200 and something, maybe with commissions $500. But, you know, I still feel like I was in red yesterday. And I was really fighting to get back to green yesterday and finish down not that much. But still, a third red day, that would take the air out of my sails. Anyway, thank you very much for joining. Thank you guys on YouTube too. If you don't mind giving us a thumb up, that would be highly appreciated. I'll see you all tomorrow, traders. Have a great day. Bye-bye.
Thank you for watching our video. Before you go, we invite you to join the TradeNet Trading Room for a free 14-day trial. TradeNet has educated more than 30,000 professional traders worldwide since 2004, and its Trading Room is one of the world's leading trading communities. Click here to start your free trial. If you like this video, please subscribe to our YouTube channel where you can view many more stock trading videos. Questions or comments, please submit them below.